Hey ladies, it's Emily, and I wanted to this week take a moment to share with you a few questions and some feedback that I had from coaching meetings with clients this week. So for those of you lady real estate agents who are out there building a team, a couple of things that you really, really have to keep in mind. And I'm going to come at this from two different perspectives because I have two hiring situations that I'm dealing with right now with current clients, and they're a little bit unique. So in one of the scenarios, the client just hired her first admin person, so her first executive administrative assistant. And the personality types of the admin are generally very different than the personality type of the successful, really big go-get-em agent, right? And so I want you to think about if you're that, you know, uber type A personality where you're out there and you're going and getting them all the time, to expect that your assistant is going to be that same way is completely unrealistic. You hired them because they're good at details, or hopefully you hired them because they're good at details. They're generally a little bit more reserved. They're not pushing themselves outside their comfort zone as much. You might not even know where your comfort zone exists unless it comes to things like hugging and touchy-feely and do I really have to sit down long enough to have a conversation with you? So real estate agents are a lot of times those successful female real estate agents are pinging all over the place. They're boom, 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 boom. So two things that you need to really, really be mindful of if you've hired your first administrative assistant or if you're about to hire that person is that you need to have an onboarding program in place. A lot of times what I see is that the agent is just wanting them to job shadow them. They're wanting them to go everywhere with them or to be exposed to everything all at one time. Guys, we don't learn like that, right? That's not how it works. You're not going to set your person up for success if you just wing them into everything all at one time. We need to have a systematic approach to what they're going to be exposed to. It's best for skill development if we can be exposed to one thing, learn that, understand it, become proficient at it, and then move on to the next thing, rather than learning a little bit of this, dipping my toe in the water here, and then a little bit of this, and a little bit of this, and a little bit of this. Now, I understand that the real estate industry is not set up so that you can move your person systematically from one step to the next to the next. However, you can set up a training calendar and an onboarding program that will allow you to do that with a little bit more strategy. Right? So it's important that you're thinking about those things because you have been in the business for generally most of the agents that I work with, or if you're watching this, you've probably been in the business for a couple of years and you may have forgotten how much you know, right? And they don't know what they don't know. So we need to walk them slowly through step by step by step. And it's not about micromanaging. It's about really understanding what are the things that they need to know right off the bat, not giving them a little piece and a little piece and a little piece of everything that you're doing. Too confusing. And you're going to burn them out very, very quickly. And probably within less than 6 months, they will leave you because they're so pissed at you and they have no idea how to follow you pinging around, right? You need them and their personality type, and it's going to be very frustrating for you, but I need you to slow yourself down, get an onboarding program in place, get a training calendar in place, and time block that stuff. If you're not proficient at time blocking, I do have a productivity, get shit done productivity planner that would be a great way for you to, that would support that. And if you're interested, I can email that to you. Okay, so onboarding program, training calendar. The next thing is when you hire a buyer's agent, I had a conversation with a client today who hired a buyer's agent. Something that's really important about hiring a buyer's agent is that you have to teach them how to lead gen first and foremost. They are coming into your business and you, and in order to help you with the capacity that you have. And it's important that they can also sustain themselves, right? So we need to teach them how to lead gen. And there's many, many ways that you can lead gen. They don't have to be making cold calls. I would encourage a piece of that. We want to push them outside of their comfort zone a little bit, right? But again, with the buyer's agent, it's really important that you have an onboarding program and that you have a training calendar in place, right? So it can be something as simple as, you know, make sure that your Google calendars are integrated so that you can work together more efficiently and more fluidly. And then make sure that you know their numbers, that you're tracking their numbers. I have another client whose person has been working for them. Their buyer's agent has been working for them for a handful of months. And, you know, the agent was really upset because she felt like the buyer's agent was not producing. And when we sat down and really looked at the numbers, that person was actually producing more than what everyone on the team realized. And so the numbers are going to give you and the buyer's agent a guide for, do I need to kick it in the ass a little bit here? Or can I, you know, like, should I be celebrating my successes? So there's a couple of different ways for you to go about the training program or the training process, but it's important for you to have those things in place. So you need to have an onboarding program in place, right? Something that allows them to come into the business and to understand the culture of your company. You need to have a training calendar in place at least for the first 90 days. Now, you don't have to have it all planned out, but at least the first 90 days. And then you need to make sure that you know their numbers. If you have somebody on your team who's bringing production in, we've got to have a way to hold them accountable and for them to know when they've done a really good job so that you're not bitching at them and that they're not feeling frustrated. So those are my three things for you today. Onboarding program, a training calendar, and they've got to know their numbers. So if you need help with that, please reach out to me. I'm more than happy to have a conversation with you about what that looks like and how we can get started in a program if that's something that makes sense for you. I love you guys so much. Hope you're having an amazing week, and I look forward to seeing you on the next episode. Bye. Have a great day.